Since thousands of years, Ayurveda recommends teeth brushing. In ancient India, people used to use twigs of herbs as toothbrush. Even in many parts of India, you can see many people using twigs of certain plants and trees for brushing nowadays also. We often see that the incidence of dental caries is lesser in them than those who use regular paste and brushes. Let us find out the benefits of ancient method of toothbrushing. During ancient times, twigs of trees were used as toothbrush. There was no need of any paste because the twig itself was having required medicinal qualities. The edge of the twig was chewed to form bristles. The bristles were sufficient to reach all corners of teeth and clean them. The medicinal qualities of the herb is sufficient enough to prevent caries and plaque forming. The plant selected should have astringent, pungent or bitter taste. Bitter tasting herbs like neem have potent antimicrobial property, which is very beneficial for oral cavity hygiene. Also, bitter taste helps to improve taste and fight bad breath and anorexia. Pungent tasting herbs help to improve salivation, helping to flush out toxins from mouth. Astringent tasting herbs such as Khadira, that is Acacia catechu, help to heal gum wounds and oral ulcers. This also helps to fight bad breath. This is the list of plants that are commonly used as toothbrush. To use the twig as a toothbrush, the thickness of the twig should be approximately equal to the tip of one's little finger. It should be 12 angula in length, approximately 22.6 centimeters. The tip of the twig should be chewed a little to make it as brush. Interesting fact about Meswak. Meswak is called as Pilu or Salvadora persica. This herb is marketed nowadays as the twig of choice for toothbrush of ancient times. But quite interestingly, this herb has not been enlisted as the toothbrush of choice both in Charaka Samhita and Ashtanga Hridayam. Though this herb is mentioned by both the textbooks for many other purposes on many other occasions, except for brushing teeth. That does not mean that Meswak is not a good toothbrush. It just might be the case that it was not commonly used for the purpose of brushing teeth in olden days. Nowadays, a lot of herbal toothpaste are in the market. I really doubt their benefits. Nevertheless, they seem to be better than all the chemical paste. All these paste do is to produce some froth, giving us a mental satisfaction that some rinsing is happening on the teeth, which actually doesn't happen. Of course, they help to get rid of a bad breath problem, at least temporarily, but the same can be achieved simply by chewing a clove or cardamom. I rate tooth powders higher than toothpaste. At least they are solid enough to reach corners of teeth angles, which any brush of any number of grooves and size fail to reach. There are a couple of traditional tooth powders called as Dashana Samskara Churna and Dashana Kanti Churnam, the links to details of which are given in the video description. Tongue scraping. Tongue scrapers should not be sharp edged and should be curved, and it should be made of metals like gold, silver, copper, tin or brass. The dirt deposited at the root of the tongue gives rise to foul smell, so the tongue should be scraped regularly. To learn more, please visit easyayurveda.com.